We're having so many handhelds nowadays. But is the PS Vita Slim the king of them all? Let's find out.
Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. It's awesome that you're tuning in. So in this video, we are going to take a close look at the PS Vita Slim. Yes, because a lot of people were saying, hey, why should you even buy a Chinese handheld? Because the PS Vita can do it. So I was thinking, hey, do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to grab myself and PlayStation Vita Slim. I already did a review and a naughty video about the PS Vita, but this is the Slim Edition. And the Slim Edition already says it. It's a more like a less, would not say powerful, but a less quality version. Yeah, we're also going to do a side-by-side comparison with the original Vita, so you know what I'm talking about. But nevertheless, we're going to take a closer look at this device. Is this thing worth getting? And is this better than the Chinese handhelds? Before you're going to say yes, I'm going to type it here in the comments. Be gentle. Don't be the keyboard knight. Just stay tuned and consider subscribing, hit the bell, becoming the way of good family, and let's go and let's talk about the naughty part of the PS Vita. When it comes to the PS Vita, but also the Chinese handhelds, you need to take consideration every single handheld has its pros and cons. Simply because there is always they mess up, or there's always they are missing due of I think they don't care, or it just need to be a budget product. So therefore I just wanted to do a quick overview of these handhelds, because they are more like, let's say, comparable with the PS Vita, what they can do, and of course the price. So let's go. Okay, the first one I wanted to do a quick look at is the Retro Game 350M. And the reason why, because I am just a big fan of this mean machine. It weighs like a ton, simply because of the metal shell. Combined with the beautiful IPS display and the open Dingux, we had a lot of new possibilities. Homebrew games, we could play a lot of retro games, because this was one big naughty metal system. And the naughty part about it, we can even run it up to PlayStation 1. Pretty cool in my opinion. We had a lot of different Retro Game 350. The reason why I chose the metal version, because I like it, because it feels more durable. Because all the other versions like the P and a normal 350 have more like the plastic fantastic shell. And overall, I think the 350M was a very nice competitor back in the day. And if you're looking at the PS Vita, yeah, I think it's a really good competitor. The only thing is the price. The price was quite huge and because of the metal shell. And they are still being sold in many different colors. Nevertheless, the 350M, I love this device, but the price itself is getting really close when you look at PS Vita, and I think that's the reason why people were mentioning it, or mentioning the PS Vita a lot. Another favorite of the community, I can say the Retroid Pocket number 2. I really love the device for what it is. It doesn't come in the metal version like the previous one I've shown you. This is just a plastic fantastic, but still feels like a very durable product. And I did a review not a long time ago, and I think the Retroid Pocket 2 is a very nice piece of hardware. Simply because we're having Android, and Android gives us so much new options. Depends a little bit what kind of version, because there is an Android 6 and 8 out there. And the possibilities are quite big. Simply because with the Android combined with the controls, there is sadly no touchpad or touchscreen on the thing. That would make this thing way better in my opinion. An IPS display that looks very colorful. We had a lot of power, and we even had the option to run Dreamcast that the PS Vita not can do, as I'm making this video so far I know. But yeah, take into consideration that the power is more like combination with the chipset. Dreamcast is not running perfectly. It's still a little bit glitched out at the moment. So does it run more options, more platforms? Yes, but we couldn't run perfectly. So for my opinion, that is not a pass. So with the Retroid Pocket 2, I love this design. I love the handheld for this and the way how they present it, the service, everything. So they're doing a great job. So Retroid Pocket 2 is a nice competition for the PS Vita Slim. But when it comes to the build quality, it comes really close, but it is not really the same. So the next generation of the RK or Rockchip handhelds, we're giving this thing or the PS Vita a new competition. Most of them are made from plastic. I know the RK 2020 is in a metal version. I don't owe it, and I'm not intending to buying it. Because in the end, I think it is a great device, the same like the Pal Kitty RGB number 10. Yeah, it's a really, I love the form factor. It plays very comfortable. Yeah, what you can see, the shoulder buttons are completely different. It's a smaller display in combination with completely different software because it doesn't run on Android. Nevertheless, the idea behind it is exactly the same. Most of them are running on a RetroArch, or this is what you're going to get with these Powerkey, the RGB 10 or RK 2020. I think these are pretty similar to each other. Nevertheless, when it comes to the capabilities of running games, this is what you're going to get with these systems. So let's go on to another one, another favorite of mine. Okay, so I just want to do a quick look at the Retro Game Plus. So take consideration, there was a 2-year anniversary edition. I think this one is not for sale, the only one that is for sale is just the transparent or the black color. And I think the one was also with a 60 FPS display joystick. I really love the D-pad of this thing, but it was more like, I think you can compare this thing with a PSP, not with a PS Vita, because the PS Vita is just on another level and also a different price. These things were going around 50 bucks, I'm seeing it correctly, and the PS Vita, they are way more expensive. But when you're looking at both systems, this is just, yeah, it's not really a comparison, but just wanted to include it because when it comes to the PS Vita, you need to do a lot of stuff with it to get it to the naughty part. And in combination, this thing is quite expensive to buy. And when you're looking at the Retro Game 2-year anniversary edition, even the cheaper versions, they are maybe half the price, but beside the open dingus that can run a lot of great stuff, and it also runs PlayStation 1, it's still not a competition. Okay guys, so I already did an unboxing video about the PS Vita and how is it in 2020 and maybe also in the future. And we're going to do a side-by-side comparison with the normal version because I want to show you what is the quality difference between those. In the end, if you're looking at the PS Vita in combination with all of these Chinese handhelds, the quality of the Sony PS Vita is just the next level and none of them are going to reach this level. But I must say that the slim version feels cheaper and looks cheaper. First of all, when you're powering on the device itself, I noticed one thing. When you're putting it in standby mode, the battery basically lasts forever. And that is something that I really appreciate with the PS Vita. And that is the one first thing you can notice if you compare this with a Chinese handheld. So the device is running on the RetroArch, so that gives us a lot of great possibilities. Yeah, the display itself is not an IPS. They downgraded it from the OLED from the normal version to a basic version. It's just, so far I understand, a full HD. So it's a very high resolution display, something that none of these Chinese handhelds have at the moment, or you're going to get a GPD win that costs maybe. If you manage to get your hands on a PlayStation Vita Slim that has the possibility to do all of these awesome things, yeah, then they're having the other thing that we need to reconfigure everything yourself. So if you manage to do all of those things, yeah, I can say that this thing has a lot of capabilities, like you can say a Retroid Pocket 2 or a Retro Game 350. So when you're looking at this and you're looking at the price points, all the things you need to do for it, you will have a completely different level when it comes to device itself. A beautiful LCD display, it can do so many great things with it. We're having RetroArch that has a lot of possibilities, and maybe in the future we have some more possibilities. That's something we need to see in the future. But for now, we're just doing some quick gameplays just to show you how good is this thing capable of running the games and how good is this PS Vita Slim with the naughty software on it. Alright, so let's try the first game. It's an arcade main game. It's the Beefcake Man and Dinosaurs. But even if it's not a Retina display like the previous model, it looks amazing. The D-pad is super clickish. It's a very tiny D-pad, but you can see that this is just a quality product. Oh yeah. We got some good sound. I must say that I have some handhelds in the collection that have better audio than this. Oh crap, I'm too fluffy to jump. Oh! Okay, so let's try now and beat him up again. That's the way you're going to play with the analog stick, it plays fantastic. Alright, so I did notice with the Super Famicom or Super Nintendo that the sound itself is not that, the sound levels are not as great compared with the other versions. But yeah, 16-bit stuff runs pretty fine. God damn it. Okay, so, and of course, PlayStation 1 runs perfectly on this device. Sorry for the recording, it's very hard to record from it simply because it has a lot of reflection of the display itself. There are quite some different settings when it comes to the PlayStation 1, but this is just on the smooth settings. We can even upscale it so far and see in the menu. So there are quite some different options out there. And a great addition to the PS Vita that we can play PSP games. And there is where we're going to get the most problems with most of these handhelds, because none of them are running this game, or better said, running the platform not perfectly. Having a lot of problems like glitching, or games are just basically unplayable because we don't have the power to emulate the PSP, and with the PS Vita we don't have any problems whatsoever. Okay, so when you're looking at the PS Vita systems, it's just amazing to see what you can do with these mean machines. Take consideration, I will do a side-by-side extended comparison with the two systems. Yeah, sadly there's only one downside to this PS Vita stuff, is when you're thinking, hey, let's get a Slim, maybe those are cheaper. So far I understand of when you're looking at both prices, these things are very expensive to get. So therefore I just wanted to make this side-by-side comparison in the future, because there's a lot of to talk about and a lot of differences between the system. I just want to do a quick peek at the two systems, and I think there are a lot of great capabilities when it comes to playing retro games. Yeah, I think the PS Vita, I completely understand why people are dropping the comments, because in the end it's a high quality product, but there are quite some differences when you're looking at the PlayStation Slim when I'm playing with it and the normal 1000 or the versions with the Retina display. The final question, my friends, is this device the ultimate retro king? And to get and to buy? I think it's not. And the reason why is very simple. The PlayStation Vita is a beautiful device. So when you're looking at the quality, nothing beats the PlayStation Vita. When you're looking at the functionalities, yeah, it's great that we can finally play the PlayStation Portable, PlayStation 1 perfectly. And with the combination of this nice LCD display, it looks amazing. But when you're looking at the other devices, they have something that the PlayStation Vita doesn't have. So all the other devices have the option to just buy it and just use it. All of these devices will need some knowledge when it comes to OpenDingux, Linux, RetroArch, whatsoever. And if you want to go with the PS Vita and do a little bit of a naughty and mod it yourself, there are all things you need to check out and could take in consideration. So that's wherefore I'm saying the PS Vita, I love for what it is. I think it's a high quality product. If you want to play PSP, yeah, of course, this is just the best way to go through PS Vita games. It's a really cool all-round device. But I think another thing, and that is just the biggest flaw or the problem I'm having, getting one for cheap. If you can buy this thing for 50, 60 bucks, yeah, of course you can buy it. You can mod it and you have a great device for not a lot of money. So in the end, it's all of the question, what kind of games do you want to play? Do you want to play some retro games, more like the old school stuff? You can buy yourself a retro game and just play these games. But if you want to have the more demanding games, like the PSP, yeah, you really need to get a PS Vita or a high-end device. But then we're going to get the question, why should you pay $100, $150 for a Chinese handheld that you can get yourself a PS Vita? So that's something you need to take consideration. It's all up to you. I want to thank you for watching, consider subscribing, hit the little bell, become the Wicked family, and I will hope to see you in the next video. Maybe in PS Vita video. Yeah.